Hello and welcome to our Holy Communion service of St. James's. Wherever you are in the world, you are welcome in the love of Jesus. All the words on the screen are for you to follow. My words are in orange and your words are in blue. Now you may wish to have some bread or wine or juice to share alongside us as we sit at the Lord's table. And our theme for this service is taking responsibility. And so let's take a few moments just to sit quietly and invite the Lord to come and sit with us. Is here.
His spirit is with us.
Alleluia, Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed.
Alleluia. Almighty God, to whom
all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
The risen Jesus appeared to his disciples and said, "Peace be with you. And the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you."
And we now sing our hymn, "The King of Love, My Shepherd Is."
Thank you.
done things this week that we may not have been proud of. Perhaps we've had a crossword or we haven't had patience with somebody. So let's just take a few minutes just to bring our thoughts to God and ask Him, please forgive us. Father eternal,
giver of life and grace, we have sinned against you and against our neighbour in what we have thought, in what we have said and done, through ignorance, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We have wounded your love and marred your image in us. We are sorry and ashamed and repent of all our sins for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us. Forgive us all that is past and lead us out from the darkness to walk as children of light. Amen.
Jesus gave his life for us on the cross, so that we can be forgiven. And to all who are truly sorry and believe and trust in him, Jesus says, your sins are forgiven. Go and sin no more.
Amen. Thanks be to God.
We now have our reading given to us by Riona McNulty from Scotland, and it is John chapter 10, verse 11 to 18.
I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. The hired hand, who's not the shepherd and doesn't own the sheep, sees the wolf coming and leaves the sheep and runs away. And the wolf snatches them and scatters them. The hired hand runs away because a hired hand does not care for the sheep. I am the good shepherd. I know my own, and my own know me, just as the Father knows me, and I know the Father. I lay down my life for the sheep. I have other sheep that do not belong to this fold. I must bring them also, and they will listen to my voice, so there will be one flock, one shepherd. For this reason the Father loves me, because I lay down my life in order to take it up again. No one takes it from me, but I lay it down of my own accord. I have power to lay it down, and I have power to take it up again. I have received this command from my Father.
This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
How are you at taking responsibility for things? I don't mean in the sense of taking the blame, although that's good if you own up to something that you've done, and it's usually pretty good for humility as well, and humility's definitely a good quality for us as Christians. Like owning up to the fact that you put a dent in the chaplaincy car. Embarrassing, but good for my humility. But back to the point, taking responsibility for something that needs to be done, a task, a job, or a ministry. I've often seen the following being quoted, especially in church circles, where all kinds of things need to be done, but sometimes volunteers can be a bit in short supply. It goes like this. This is a little story about four people named Everybody, Somebody, Anybody, and Nobody. There was an important job to be done, and everybody was sure that somebody would do it. Anybody could have done it, but nobody did it. Somebody got angry about that because it was everybody's job. Everybody thought that anybody could do it, but nobody realised that everybody wouldn't do it. It ended up that everybody blamed somebody, when nobody did what anybody could have done. It's far easier to understand when you see it written down and you've got time to think it through. But I'm sure you get the gist of it. And I wonder if Peter felt that way in our reading last week when Jesus gave him responsibility for doing a job. Listen again to what was in our reading last week. Feed my lambs, tend my sheep, feed my sheep. I also wonder though if the other disciples felt a little jealous that Jesus had given the job to Peter, especially after Peter had let him down so badly. But then again, they had too. There had been that time when James and John, we read about it in Mark chapter 10, they'd actually asked Jesus if they could sit either side of him in the fullness of his kingdom. They fancied the honour and the power, but they hadn't reckoned on the cost. But even so, the rest of the disciples then seemed to argue about who was greatest. And it had only been a short time earlier that Jesus had told them about receiving the kingdom of God like a little child. Now, he had to tease out the fact that the least would be the greatest. And about everybody being a servant or even a slave to everybody else in the kingdom of God. Children are so often very eager to help. They quickly volunteer themselves. Can I help? Please! Can I help? Adults have often lost that eagerness, anything for a quiet life. And the rest of the disciples might have been quite happy just to let Peter get on with the job. We too might be happy just to let the leader get on with the job. Jesus gave it to Peter, so obviously it's the job of the leader. Why? Feed my lambs, tend my sheep, feed my sheep. Oh yes, that's obviously the job of the leader, the minister, the pastor, literally the shepherd. Jesus passed the job of the shepherd over to Peter. Succession planning. Good job, Jesus. Yay! Just one small difficulty there. As Christians, who are we meant to be like? Stock answer, Jesus. In our reading today, who was Jesus? The Good Shepherd. What should we be? Good Shepherds. Sorted. Yes, there are particular responsibilities that Christians have, particular ministries or callings. But the fact is that we're all called to ministry. We all have a general responsibility. We're all called to love. We're all called to serve. We're all called to be good shepherds because we're all called to be like Jesus. Crazy thing is, we're both sheep and shepherds. Let's try and get our heads around that. In our reading, Jesus explains the qualities of the good shepherd. He lays down his life for his sheep. He cares for his sheep. He knows his sheep. And as for the sheep, well, they know him. They listen to him. They live together as one with others from outside the flock. They are part of one flock with one shepherd. We model ourselves on Jesus, the Good Shepherd, but however well we manage it, in terms of imitating him, there is only one ultimate shepherd, Jesus himself. He trumps every other. So, if we are by imitation shepherds, but also sheep, what should be the characteristics of our lives? Well, firstly, we too are called to lay down our lives for the sheep. That is, we are to give our all for one another. As Jesus says, love one another. And from last week, that love is agape love. Total commitment to one another as to Jesus. Anything less falls short of the mark. But with Jesus and Peter's response last week, we know that Jesus will take as much as we're able to give. He'll accept it graciously, but there's always room for more. Taking that next step, that next level of commitment, if you like. Loving even more. Taking upon ourselves that agape love. Secondly, we're to care for one another. To be concerned about one another's well-being, so that our care and concern helps others to thrive and to grow. And thirdly, we're to know one another. Not in any kind of busybody way, but in a caring way, so that we are best able to know one another's needs and how we can meet those needs. In God's flock, God's family, we should never be strangers to one another. Strangers are only strangers the first time they meet. Then they're family. All of us, as sheep, are meant to know Jesus, to know him in the most intimate way possible. And as we've heard earlier this year, that needs us to listen and to hear carefully to him and to one another as fellow disciples, through study, through prayer, through sharing together with one another as we learn from each other what it is to really know Jesus from a host of different perspectives and situations. Jesus' words remind us of the contrast between the good shepherd and the hired hand. The hired hand runs away when life gets difficult or even dangerous. They don't really care for the sheep. They're just doing the job for what they can get out of it. They don't know the sheep, and their hearts aren't really in it. May we never sink to the level of just being hired hands, in it for what we can get out of it, without real concern for the sheep, for one another, and without that total commitment to Jesus that he asks for. You see, Jesus' call to Peter is a call to us too. So you need to reflect on how you can feed his lambs. Nurture and teach those who are babies in the faith and help them to grow as Christians. To tend his sheep, to look after, protect and support one another, those who've committed themselves as disciples of Jesus. And to feed his sheep. To encourage and teach one another as his disciples, to be mature in our faith, to be able to support the next generations as they too grow into the faith. And all of this will involve commitment in terms of love and service, to give of our best and beyond in sacrificial love, and to respond eagerly, as little children. Can I help, please? Let's pray. Father, help us to take on board the responsibility that you have given us, to really demonstrate in our lives, in our church, in our communities, that sacrificial love that you have entrusted to us. And give us that shepherd heart for your people. Amen.
Now we stand to sing our song, The Lord's My Shepherd, I'll Not Want.
The Lord's my shepherd, I'll not want. He makes me lie in pastures green. He leads me by the still, still waters. His goodness restores my soul. And I will trust in you. And I will trust in you alone. For your endless mercy follows me. Your goodness will lead me. Guides my ways in righteousness, and He anoints my head with oil, and my cup it overflows with joy. I feast on His pure delights, and I will trust in
have our prayers brought to us from Marissa McInnes from Cornwall.
Let's pray. And as we pray, when I say the words, Lord, hear us, please respond with, Lord, graciously hear us. Thank you, Lord God, for the privilege of knowing you, knowing that you loved us before we were born, knowing that you sent Jesus to earth to rescue us from our sin, knowing that Jesus shows us how to live life fully, how to serve you and serve others, and how to die well. As your church here in Fuerteventura, in the UK and around the world, we ask you to increase and strengthen our faith so that those around us can see your love and your power. Lord, hear us.
Lord graciously hear us.
We pray for Bob and Judy as they lead the Fuerteventura chaplaincy, that you will guide, inspire, and protect them and their wider family. As we support them practically and in prayer, may we all use the gifts you have given us to build each other up, so the Christian witness on the island will be visible to all those who don't yet know you. Lord, hear us.
Lord graciously hear us.
As Her Majesty the Queen mourns the loss of her husband Philip, we pray that you, Lord, will uphold her in her grief, be her comfort and her strength. Be with all the royal family at this sad time as they mourn. We pray for our archbishops and thank you for their leadership. May they hear your voice and be led by you. Lord, hear us.
Lord graciously hear us.
We pray for our families and friends, especially those who are finding life tough. Be close to the brokenhearted, the lonely, the sick, the grieving, those who are worried, suffering financially, and those who feel they've been forgotten. Touch them with your love, your healing touch, and have compassion on them. Lord, hear us.
Lord graciously hear us.
We remember fellow Christians around the world who pay a huge price for following Christ. Those who are persecuted, living in hard to reach remote communities. Those who suffer famine, disease, and those being badly affected by COVID. We bring to you, Lord, your church in South Sudan, the Democratic Republic of Congo, Myanmar, Ethiopia, the Yemen, and India. May your people in these places know the answers to their prayers. Lord, hear us.
Lord graciously hear us.
Lord God, give us thankful hearts for all your goodness to us. You have entrusted us with much. Help us to use what you have given us wisely, so that others will see the glory of Christ in us and long to find Christ for themselves. We commit ourselves and our prayers, said and unsaid, to you, and pray that you will use us as lights in this world to shine for your glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Merciful Father,
accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
And now we bring our prayers together in the Lord's Prayer. And pray in the version on the screen or the version that you know best, or in your own language.
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
As part of the offering of yourself to God, you may wish to send a donation for the work of the chaplaincy across Fuerteventura. Some of what we receive is given to support the Spanish Association Against Cancer and some for Cheer Fund for International Relief and Development Work. All the details for donations are on our website. And now we sing to the Lord, I believe in God the Father, and we affirm our faith in that hymn.
Spirit.
So we give thanks in our Eucharistic prayer. The Lord is here.
His Spirit is with us.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
It is always right to give you thanks, God our Creator, loving and faithful, holy and strong. You made us and the whole universe and filled your world with life. You sent your Son to live among us, Jesus our Saviour, Mary's child. He suffered on the cross. He died to save us from our sins. He rose in glory from the dead. And you send your Spirit to bring new life to the world and clothe us with power from on high. And so we join the angels to celebrate and sing.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest.
Father,
on the night before he died, Jesus shared a meal with his friends. He took the bread and thanked you. He broke it and gave it to them, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this to remember me." After the meal, Jesus took the cup of wine. He thanked you and gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood, the new promise of God's unfailing love. Do this to remember me." Jesus Christ has died. Jesus Christ is risen. Jesus Christ will come again. Father, as we bring this bread and wine and remember his death and resurrection, send your Holy Spirit that we who share these gifts may be fed by Christ's body and his blood. Pour your Spirit on us that we may love one another, work for the healing of the earth, and share the good news of Jesus as we wait for his coming in glory. For honour and praise belong to you, Father, with Jesus, your Son, and the Holy Spirit, one God, for ever and ever.
Amen.
We break this bread to share in the body of Christ.
Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in the one bread.
Every time we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. All are welcome at Christ's table. Eat this and remember Jesus.
Amen.
Drink this and remember Jesus.
Amen.
Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and the blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory.
Amen.
All our notices are on our website, which is www.30church.org. And we must remember that the chaplaincy AGM takes place on the 26th of April, which is next Monday. And it's at 11 o'clock via the Zoom web link, which you can find on the AGM webpage link. And all the relevant documents can be found there. Nominations for wardens and council members must be completed ahead of the meeting. And we have continuing with our gifts of love. Any bags of food or toiletries, please drop them off at Casabob or church or request a pickup. Our Sunday services are now in person in church as well as online, but things could change as levels change. Our midweek in-person fellowship groups in Corralejo, El Cotillo and Caleta di Fuste will be meeting this week. All are welcome. And please consult the website calendar and social media regularly for updates on all our services and meetings. And now our hymn, I Will Sing the Wondrous Story.
Thank you.
called and loved by God the Father and kept safe by Jesus Christ. Mercy, peace and love be yours in abundance from God the Father, God the Son and God the Holy Spirit. And the blessing of God, Father, Son and Holy Spirit be with you now and always. Amen. Go in the peace of the risen Christ to love and serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ. Amen.